As SpaceX, Starships, and Elon Musk aims to make us a multi-planetary species, many wonder what life on Mars will be like. If you're one of them, well, you're in the right place. In this video, we'll dive into what the first 10,000 days on the red planet could be. Get ready to have your mind blown. Day 1. Day 1 kicks off with a Martian milestone as five starships gracefully touch down on the dusty red surface of Mars. These unmanned marvels aren't just any spacecraft. They are pioneers delivering crucial life support systems that will lay the foundation for human colonization. Imagine the scene. Previous Martian rovers sent by nations worldwide bear witness as the starships make their historic descent on the red planet. What's in their cargo? Essential gear like solar panels, backup fuel, oxygen, water, dried food, and even waste management systems. Think futuristic survival kits. SpaceX's ships also pack the first habitation pods and a suite of medical supplies, along with tools for scientific experiments that are set to expand our understanding of the red planet. But that's not all. One of them carries something truly futuristic, a Starlink communication network for Mars. Before it even lands, this spacecraft deploys the network into orbit, a crucial step for future communications. You can think about it as a Martian Wi-Fi, ensuring that when humans arrive, they're connected to Earth and each other. And let's not forget the power source. 7 football fields worth of solar panels are part of the payload, ready to harness sunlight to power the burgeoning colony. Sure, Martian sunlight might not be as strong as what we get on Earth, but these panels are designed to squeeze every bit of energy out of the incoming light rays. Rovers, robotic dogs that seem to come straight out of a sci-fi flick, are unleashed onto the Mars surface. These high-tech critters, the fruit of many experiments and years of hard work, are courtesy of Boston Dynamics and SpaceX. Now we have made them the vanguard of exploration, scouting and preparing the way for future human footsteps. Day 2. There is no time for rest here on the surface of Mars. It's day 2 and the team kicks into high gear with the first base setup. If you were there, you could see rovers and robots hustling about, deploying solar arrays and gearing up for fuel production experiments. They've got these rovers out there drilling deep for icy water deposits, while others are busy with something called the Sabatier process. It's pretty cool, actually. They're snagging CO2 from the Martian air, mixing it with hydrogen from mined ice, and then zapping it with heat and pressure to churn out water, oxygen, and even methane fuel. These will turn out to be crucial elements needed for humanity's survival on this beautiful but hostile planet. Also, these multi-use rovers are on a mission to flatten and melt Martian regolith, that's the loose soil, to create a mega landing pad. Why? Well, it cuts down on all that messy dirt and rock swirling around during future landings, making things safer for the next arrivals. As you can understand, the entire population on Mars right now is only made up of robots. These pieces of technology are busy creating the best environment possible for astronauts who will reach the red planet in less than 3 years from now. 2 years and 5 months later. And indeed, 2 years and 5 months later, starships carrying a total of 30 astronauts land on Mars. 10 additional cargo ships accompany them, carrying an oversupply of life support. These first astronaut settlers are scientists, engineers, medical specialists, and military personnel with scientific backgrounds. They all have to stay on Mars for the full 2 years and 2 months. This is not a short-term visit. It is a mission to make life sustainable and multiplanetary. During the first week on Mars, the poor astronauts suffer from the effects of low gravity after the 7-month journey and have weaker muscles. The first week is used to acclimate to the gravity of the red planet and celebrate surviving the journey. The new settlers live in starships that they landed in. The crew begins to adapt to their new surroundings. Life on Mars is harsh. The average temperature outside is minus 63 degrees Celsius or minus 81 degrees Fahrenheit, with a maximum of 20 degrees Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit in the summer at the equator. Windstorms are common on Mars, lifting rust-colored dust into the atmosphere that can cover the entire planet. Mars also experiences quakes. Orbiters monitoring the climate on Mars act as weather satellites, warning astronauts of incoming dust storms and changes in the weather. Sometimes, when looking out of their Starship's windows, astronauts wonder whether humanity will actually make it or not. By the way, are you curious to know what's on their menu? Rye, radishes, tomatoes, beans, carrots, and spuds, all grown right here. And get this, the astronauts' waste? Yeah, it's all recycled back into the mix as plant food. Talk about sustainable living, right? Next up, rumor has it Mars is getting a special delivery. Fish, of all things. Now that's one small step for fish, one giant leap for Mars-based cuisine. 5 years later. 5 years later, Earth is buzzing with activity. SpaceX has revolutionized space travel, pumping out two starships every week from state-of-the-art factories. Each one costs a cool $5 million. That adds up fast. 104 starships a year, all lined up and ready for the big show. But here's the catch. Earth and Mars don't sync up in orbit. They only get close enough for a launch every 2 years and 2 months. And when that window opens, sometimes just a dozen days to pick from, with launch windows as slim as 30 minutes to 2 hours. Imagine the scene. Earth's spaceports bustling with anticipation. Cargo and crewed starships stand poised, waiting for their shot at the red planet. And then it happens. One starship streaks across the cosmic void, bound for Mars. On board, the entire 30-strong crew, seasoned veterans of over 2 years on Martian soil. 6 years later. After 6 years, big changes on the Martian frontier. Humans now outnumber robots, thanks to the arrival of a second wave of settlers. Architects reach the red planet. Alongside them, a crew of scientists, engineers, and the green thumb botanists shaping the future of Mars. Meanwhile, SpaceX kicks off Depot X, the first fueling pit stop on Mars. It's basically a pit crew for future missions, pumping lifeblood into the next wave of exploration. And that's not all. They're breaking ground on a cutting-edge habitat, 3D printed from Martian soil and plant-based polymers. The outer shell shields from cosmic rays, while an inflatable inner layer adds an extra layer of safety. 7 years later, 7 years on Mars, things are really starting to take shape. With the arrival of advanced 3D printing robots, we're seeing some serious upgrades. Massive hydroponic farms cropping up, churning out most of the settlers' grub. But that's not all they're up to. Settlers are diving into underground digs, scouting out spots for future habitats. The data they dig up? It's beaming straight back to the boring company back on Earth. 8 years later, space agencies from every corner of Earth are making a beeline for Mars Base Alpha. It's like a global science fair up there, with equipment and scientists from all over setting up shop. And speaking of setting up, Jeff Bezos swoops in with a cosmic domain name, Amazon Mars, aiming to revolutionize deliveries in deep space. Blue Origin's gearing up too, prepping to ferry goods first for agencies, then for private thrill seekers. Meanwhile, back on Mars, the new Starship crew's making waves, literally. They brought fish from Earth to kickstart an aquaponic revolution in Martian greenhouses, all thanks to enough locally made water. A new era of self-sufficiency has started on the red planet. But not all journeys end in new beginnings. The first funeral on Mars marks a solemn moment. A settler's ashes scatter across Martian sands, a tribute to pioneers who shaped this new frontier. Back in our blue home, a fleet of starships hangs in low Earth orbit, packed to the brim with fuel, cargo, and passengers. When that launch window cracks open, they'll streak across the cosmos as one, supporting and docking with each other like cosmic ballet dancers on their 7-month journey to Mars. 11 years later. Welcome to the year 2035, a pivotal moment in our Martian odyssey. This year marks what we call the Great Crossing. Earth and Mars align closer than ever in what's known as perihelic opposition, slashing travel time from 7 months down to just 5. It's a game changer. Hundreds of settlers swarm the Martian surface, turning it into a bustling hub of human endeavor. Autonomous mega 3D printers roar to life, laying the groundwork for expansive bases. What once started as an international habitat now blooms into a town-sized settlement, a network of interconnected domes spanning the Martian landscape. But we're not just building homes, we're building futures. The first Martian hospital takes shape, a beacon of hope and healing in this alien world. As more facilities rise from the red sands, more hearts choose to call Mars home permanently. 15 years in, the first people with the intention of becoming permanent residents arrive on Mars. The colony crosses the 1,000-person mark. There is even a small-scale TV show that is made on the Red Planet. The first Martian marriage is watched across Earth and Mars, while exploration missions discover cave systems suitable for the development of protected underground habitats. 16 years have passed since humanity's Martian adventure began. At this point, the Boring Company Tunnel Digger touches down on Mars, signaling the dawn of Elon Musk's vision for a boring Mars company. Underground tunnels start snaking through Martian soil, creating shielded passageways and laying the groundwork for future habitats below the surface. Robotic outposts now dot the Martian landscape, acting as mining hubs and remote bases for exploration. Nation-states step into the fray, constructing smaller habitats that double as embassies, symbols of national pride against the Martian horizon. Architectural marvels rise from the rust-colored sands, blending utility with artistry as humanity's footprint on Mars evolves. Amidst these milestones, a miracle unfolds, the first human born on Mars. Scientists monitor the health of both mother and child closely, and everything is looking great. We can really say we have become a multi-planetary species. 18 years later. After 18 years, the Martian human population exceeds 7,000. The Red Planet welcomes a new wave of settlers, including commercially paying customers opting for two-year stays. With many people now living together on Mars, the first political system is established. Local policies now govern daily life, crucial for fostering self-sufficiency and ensuring the colony's survival. Technological advancements mark milestones in Martian healthcare and energy infrastructure. The arrival of a bioprinter at the hospital heralds a new era of medical innovation, allowing for the printing of human organs and tissues. Concurrently, a dedicated maternity ward opens to support the increasing number of births among Martian residents. In a bid for energy independence, construction commences on the first components of a nuclear fusion power plant. This ambitious project aims to reduce reliance on solar panels ferried from Earth with each successive mission. 23 years later, it's 2047, the year of the Martian explorers. The first person climbs Olympus Mons. It's 2.5 times taller than Mount Everest, making it the tallest mountain and volcano in the solar system. The 9.5-month journey tests the limits of the new flexible spacesuits. The first MNRA manufacturing facility is operational, allowing the people of Mars to be vaccinated when they return to Earth. Schools are now being built as workers begin to move their families to Mars. Blue Origin's first fully autonomous orbiting manufacturing station arrives in the orbit of Mars. The space station processes asteroids for rare materials. It is done in space so that the Mars atmosphere is not polluted. Manufactured goods are then sent down to the Martian surface. Elon Musk opens the first Tesla Gigafactory on Mars. Here they recycle solar panel batteries, assemble, open and enclose electric transporters, and also maintain ATVs and other SpaceX transport vehicles. 26 years later, the celestial dance of Earth and Mars brings them close once more, facilitating a mass migration of tens of thousands of people and vast amounts of equipment to the Red Planet. Government officials from Earth nations, mining companies, management teams, and exploration geologists converge on Mars, establishing small company habitats across its surface. Thanks to advancements in AI robotics and the diligent efforts of a productive human workforce, Mars achieves full self-sufficiency. The colony now produces all essential goods internally: power, breathable air, water, food, and fuel, marking a remarkable leap in Martian autonomy and sustainability. Day 10,000. We finally reached day 10,000. 27 years have passed since the first settlers touched Martian soil. Imagine this. If Earth suddenly stopped sending supplies, Mars could still hold its own, but life would get pretty basic. we'd be talking survival mode, like our ancestors did. But hey, let's not dwell on what-ifs. Today, a celebration to mark 10,000 days on Mars. The first ever Martian-born human makes a historic trip to Earth. Picture them suited up in a cool robotic outfit, controlled by a brain chip from Neuralink, helping them navigate Earth's heavier gravity like a champ. Meanwhile, back on Mars, things are blooming, literally. Massive greenhouses perched over melted ice lakes near the equator burst with grasslands and woody plants. They're not just for show. These babies are churning out oxygen slowly but surely, pumping life into the Martian air. And get this, wild grass strands have been spotted sprouting up on the Martian surface. It's a day of triumph and discovery, where every blade of grass marks a step closer to turning Mars from a red dot in the sky into a second home under the stars.